Is Amazon FBA a scam? Is it legit or is it fake? Is it even real? If you're wondering any of those things and you're a beginner looking to get started on Amazon FBA, then this video is for you. What's up guys, it's Myles here. And in today's video, I wanted to talk to you about a topic that really caused me a lot of anxiety and a lot of uncertainty when I was a beginner looking to start to sell on Amazon FBA. So just as context, I was a beginner in 2016. I started selling in November 2016. So that's less than 2 years ago. And in the time since then, I've gone from being a beginner to now having a seven-figure a year business. I've sold just under $2 million. And so I kind of remember what it was like not that long ago, being a complete beginner, having all of these fears and uncertainties. And I also now know what it's like to have gone through that process myself. And what I wanted to talk to you about today were those doubts that I had about just not knowing whether it was really real or not, whether the opportunity was something that I could actually use for myself, or whether essentially, whether everybody who was telling me about it, you know, all the things that I was reading online, the videos I was watching, whether that was just an attempt to try and sell me something or not, or whether it was genuine. And so having been through both, you know, both sides in a short period of time, I think I can give you my opinion now. And so I'm gonna talk to you three main points that I think are the most important that you should know if you're wondering these same questions. Is it a scam? Is it legit? Is it fake? Is it real? And so on. So I'm gonna get straight into it with my first point, which is why is there money in selling on Amazon? So let's talk about it from the basics. What is FBA, the FBA program? So FBA stands for Fulfillment by Amazon. And there's no denying that this is a real and very powerful program that is essentially a unique opportunity. So let me explain why. Essentially what you had to do before FBA or without FBA was if you wanted to sell something online, and this is what I did when I was selling on eBay, was you had to store the goods somewhere. So you, whatever it is that you were selling, you would probably be storing them in your garage or in your house somewhere in boxes. And then anytime somebody would buy those products, you would have to take the order that the customer had bought and take it down to the post office and send it to that customer. So you can see if you have to do that one time, that's okay. But if you're selling five a day, you have to do that five times. If you're selling 50 a day, you have to do that 50 times, and so on and so forth. So you can see very quickly that, you know, not only is it gonna be a pain in the ass shipping out 100 or 1,000 units per day, it's also gonna require more and more storage space and more basically management of those products that you have. So Fulfillment by Amazon takes that whole process away from you. Amazon deals with the products. You don't actually have to see them. So that is the key benefit of the FBA program. It's real, it's scalable, and it's hands-off, whether it's one unit a day, 10, 100, 1,000, what you have to do doesn't change. The second side that we need to look at is the customer side. And Amazon is the world's largest product search engine. And to illustrate this with an example, let's say that you're selling something on your own website, on a Shopify store or something like that. You're going to get a conversion rate of around about 1%. So that means of 100 people who come to look at your product, one person will buy. On Amazon, people go to Amazon specifically looking to buy products. And what you're going to find is that that same product that you could sell on your own website where you have to get 100 customers in the door, if you sell that same product on Amazon, the conversion rate will be 10 to 20 times higher. That's not an exaggeration, that's 10 to 20 times higher. So instead of having to find 100 customers, you now only have to find 10 or 5 customers to sell the same amount of products. So you can see how powerful that is. And just to put more numbers behind this, the FBA program makes up around about 40% of Amazon's total revenue. That's about $40 billion per year. And of that money, most of that is generated by third-party sellers. So third-party means it's not Amazon. So I'm a third-party seller, and if you were to sell on Amazon, you would be a third-party seller as well. Now that group of third-party sellers that are making more than $1 million per year in revenue, that's around 20%, and I fall into that group. And that number, that 20%, is growing every year. And in fact, I think around 3% of those third-party sellers are actually selling more than $10 million per year. So let's just be very clear and say that yes, Amazon FBA itself, the concept fundamentally, it is legit. It's generating Amazon billions and billions of dollars. And there are hundreds of thousands of sellers who are also making either hundreds of thousands of dollars or millions of dollars selling on Amazon. So that much is true. But that brings me to my second point, which is, how do you identify an Amazon FBA scam? What are the warning signs that you need to look out for so that you can know whether somebody's just trying to sell you information or whether they're actually trying to help? So the first thing that I would be asking myself is, does it sound too good to be true? Now, I want to be very clear and say that even if it does sound too good to be true, this doesn't necessarily mean that somebody is trying to scam you. It may just mean that they're trying to market something to you. And if that's the case, what you then need to be able to do is read between the lines to make a good decision for yourself as to whether what they're trying to sell or market to you is worthwhile buying. And there are a couple of red flags that if I heard them, I would be very careful about trusting that source of information. The first one, and this is a pet peeve of mine, is passive income. Amazon FBA is not passive income. If you hear the concept of like making money while you sleep, making money without having to do any work, anything like that, be wary. In my experience, Amazon FBA is either a very good active source of income or at best a semi-passive source of income. If somebody's trying to sell you the passive income dream, then just be careful because either they haven't done it themselves and so they don't know what it's really like, or they're oversimplifying things to again try and part you with some of your money. Either way, be careful. The second thing is no prior experience, no skills required, that sort of thing. Think about that for a second. If everybody could do it with no experience, no skills, no knowledge, then everybody would simply just jump in and very quickly that opportunity would be gone. So you can start from zero, like with any skill or any opportunity or anything in life, you can start from zero, and in fact you have to start from zero. And then you go through a process of learning and gaining experience until you achieve success. But without that process of gaining that experience and that knowledge, you simply won't get that success. And anyone who thinks that you can completely shortcut that process, again, is either simplifying things to part you from your money, or they simply don't know because they haven't done it for themselves. The third thing that I consider a red flag is instant results. It's very similar to, you know, no experience required and that sort of thing. And it's just, no. You have to commit time for these things, guys. 6 months to a year, something like that. And if you aren't willing to commit that time, then you shouldn't expect to see results. You definitely will not see them instantaneously. A second point that I'd say about that is that you will see people generating sales results quite quickly. So in the grand scheme of things, I do think Amazon FBA is right at the top in terms of the speed with which you can start a business and see success, but it's still a business. Fundamentally, it still requires a lot of effort and a lot of time invested to get to that successful point. And I would also say that you might see people have success with their first product in their first month. A lot of the time, what you're seeing is those first sales not being generated profitably, but they're actually just getting started. And so even at that point, I wouldn't say that is successful. I would say leave that and let it go for 6 months. And then when you've seen it actually making money over a stable period of time, then you've seen success. But instant results, I don't think so. And I want to end this point with a counter argument. I did say, think like, is it too good to be true? But I definitely don't want you to think, if something sounds too good to be true, then it probably is. I hear that saying a lot. And in my experience, it's a really self-limiting belief. The way that I like to think about these things is to, if I picture somebody who's a millionaire or a billionaire, or someone who's achieved really great success in their life, somebody that I admire and I look up to, I just think like, yes, that is, maybe it's too good to be true, but somebody has clearly done it. And I hope that I am showing you that people are doing this, so it's not too good to be true. You kind of have to make a decision for yourself and really think about the intent behind what, you know, what's being shown to you, what's being presented to you. Is somebody maliciously just trying to take money from you, or are they actually genuinely trying to share something, you know, a benefit that they've gained in their life that they want to pass on to others? Think about that for yourself and make that decision. And while you're at it, leave me a comment down below and let me know whether you've seen these warning signs somewhere, and just tell me, like, you know, what did you notice and how did you feel about it when you saw those warning signs? So point number three, what to look out for. Now that we've identified the warning signs and the things to avoid, what are the positive signs that we want to actually gravitate towards if we're looking for information, or we're looking for a mentor, or we're looking for a coach, somebody to guide us through this process? So first of all, do they show real proof of their success at the thing that they're actually teaching? So that doesn't mean Lamborghinis, flashy cars, flashy things. Normally that only comes after hundreds of courses have been sold. So that's really a reflection of how good are they at marketing and of selling courses. What you actually want to see are, do they show you their Seller Central account? Do they show you their real numbers? And do they show also as well, like, ups and downs is a key thing, because it's not always up. And so if somebody makes you think that it is, you're just going to be purely disappointed when you encounter reality and find out that it's actually, you know, a series of ups and downs. And that's my second point. Are they open about the negatives, the downsides of the business? Because everything in life and in business, there's always going to be positives, and there's also always going to be negatives, the challenges, the difficult things. Those things, they don't sell so well. So if somebody doesn't want to talk about them, or they're, you know, hiding them from you, then be careful, because what they're doing is selling you a reality that doesn't exist, essentially. Amazon is a great business model, and it has a lot of challenges and a lot of problems that you need to be able to effectively deal with. So if somebody isn't telling you about them, to me, that's another red flag. That's something to avoid. The last thing is just ask around, ask in Facebook groups, ask your peers, how was that course, or how was that mentorship? What about the resources provided? Particularly look out for things like unlimited mentorship. We all only have 24 hours in the day. So if somebody is providing unlimited mentorship to 1,000 other students who are also looking for unlimited mentorship, the maths of that just doesn't really add up. So basically, if you want to know whether you can trust a certain source of information, check for proof of their real Amazon successes. Ask your peers to see whether other people have had good results with them and the information and the resources that they put out. And then also just check whether they're open and upfront about the honest realities of the business, both the positives and the negatives. And guys, with those three points we've talked about, is Amazon actually real? Yes, it is. It is a real opportunity. What are the warning signs to look out for? There are quite a few that you need to be able to identify if you don't want to be led astray. And then finally, what to actually look for to judge whether somebody or something is a good source of information or not. So guys, if you're a beginner and you've been wondering these questions, is Amazon FBA a scam? Is it fake? Is it real? Is it legit? This is my perspective, what I've learned going from being in your shoes less than 2 years ago to where I am now today. Hope you found this super valuable, guys. If you haven't already, do subscribe to this channel. My whole purpose with everything that I'm putting out is to help you get to either 6 or 7 figures a year on Amazon. If you gel with that, then do subscribe, do like the video, leave any comments or questions you have. I'll answer them all, and I will see you in the next video.